Welcome back. Now, Anaheim's George Parros is a product of Princeton University. So in addition to being one of the toughest guys around, he's also one of the smartest. Turns out he's pretty generous, too. For more on Big George, here's the Hockey Show's Carrie Milbank with today's Cisco Connecting Fan segment.
Thanks, Heidi. Look around any hockey rink this time of year and you'll see players growing out their facial hair. Guys tend to get pretty superstitious about their beards and hair this time of year, but every season, Anaheim tough guy George Parros lets his hair grow out for goodwill rather than good luck. Check out this following piece and you'll see what I mean.
Anaheim Ducks forward George Parros has achieved rock star status for his rugged play and trademark features. But this tough guy's signature locks are more substance than style.
The hair, I was always reined in by our college coach. We weren't allowed to grow it out too long. So when I first started playing pro, I decided to let her go for a while.
He looks pretty menacing, whether he's got long hair or a shaved head.
Right around that time, someone had told me about the locks of love. And so I figured if I was going to cut it, I might as well cut a lot of it off and do something good with it.
At least once a year, Parros donates his hair to charity. As his popularity in the community spreads, his ability to rally support for a worthy cause also grows.
Are you getting your hair cut today? I never really gotten the fans involved until I came to Anaheim here. The charity today is the Childhood Leukemia Foundation. They make wigs for kids with cancer who've lost their hair through chemotherapy, help their self-esteem and you know, reassimilation into their everyday life. They usually like to have around 10 inches of hair for the ponytail.
Oh no!
Oh! Get it nice and short, probably some sort of crew cut style. Maybe a little bit more length so I can grow back and cut it around December, which I like to do. That's a scary sound. She took some instruction well from my girlfriend, which is kind of funny. She knows it's the only one I'm going to get there in a year, so work turned out well.
While he may be the focal point for dedicated fans here, Parros gleans inspiration from the generosity he sees in others.
The best stories that come out of it are the little kids that get their hair cut with me because they don't know much about the world, but they want to cut their hair out to help a kid that's their age, and that's the coolest thing for me.
You look great.
Come here, fight.
Yeah, this is yours. Yeah, you're welcome, thank you.
It's crazy, it's a full-blown event now, and that's really good. I'm glad that people want to come here and do this and take part in it.
January of 2005, I got a haircut and haven't cut it since. I kept it for a while and, you know, didn't have any good reason to cut it. On November 11th of 2008, last year, my cousin passed away after a four-year fight with cancer. She's a great woman who I love dearly, and I just feel honored to have been able to do something like this in her memory.
People can get excited about it and maybe grow the awareness of it out a little bit more, but mostly you get other people to cut their hair with you and they all know they're doing it for a good cause, and it's fun to see.